Welcome to ArtHouse Radio, my friends. I am Troy. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you're doing well. This week, I'm looking at what I think is a classic film, classic war film, Crimson Tide. Now, for me, this movie gets a solid 7.8, maybe 7.9 out of 10. That's a good score. Here's why. It's action-packed. It's one of those movies that once you see it on TV or somebody starts it, you walk into a room and it's on, you finish it. You've got an A-list of actors here. Gene Hackman, Denzel Washington, James Gandolfini, Viggo Mortensen, Ricky Schroeder. Now, it's directed by Tony Scott, who did Top Gun, which I've never seen and never will, Days of Thunder, which I have seen, and I enjoyed it. And the score is by Hans Zimmer. Hans Zimmer is one of the best folks. If you don't know Hans Zimmer, look it up. So this story basically parallels the Cuban Missile Crisis. You've got a nuclear war situation. They load up this submarine with nuclear weapons, throw some top A-list actors in the sea, and send them over to Russia. Now, they lose contact with the Pentagon. So they're underwater getting attacked by Russian subs. They don't know if Russia has launched their nuclear weapons, or if not, that they were, there was the threat of that in the movie. They thought that was a very real possibility. Now they're faced with this, we were told to launch our weapons, but there's a new message that got cut off in one of the attacks, so they don't know what to do. Basically, we've got an issue of leadership. Now, I kind of wanted to talk about something specific in the movie because I think you'll find it interesting. I found this article online called Crimson Tide Movie Analyzing the Conflicts in Leadership by someone named Anand Mohan. Anand, very nice article. He talks about the two different types of leadership. One of the conflicts in the movie is that you have Gene Hackman playing the captain of the submarine, and then you have the sous chef, or XO, played by Denzel Washington, Lieutenant Hunter. And basically, when they lose contact with the Pentagon and they're not sure whether they should launch their missiles or not, Gene Hackman is what they say, what Anand says in this article, exhibiting the theory or the characteristic of contingency leadership. This is sort of a task-oriented thing. He's kind of an old dog, an old-school guy, the only submarine commander, I guess, or captain, who has seen combat and has that experience. Well, he's all for shooting these missiles. He's like, this is not about, we're not about messing around here. We've got to protect American soil. If there's anything left, they don't know. They're you know, in the ocean, not in the middle of nowhere. They don't know what's happened because they lost contact. And on the other side of that, you have Lieutenant Hunter, played by Denzel Washington. This is situational leadership. This is, this theory or type of leadership is kind of like more dependent on a leader's personal skills and their natural ability to lead in situations. Likeable, able to convince people to fight for them, to be on their side, but he has no combat experience. So this is kind of the position that the movie puts us in, this conflict about whether they should be launching or not. There are a couple of coups that take place. The different leaders take control a couple of different times. Now, this movie is from 1995, so there's a spoiler alert coming up in 3, 2, 1. Glad you stayed with me because it's from 1995 and you should have seen it already. It turns out that Russia had not launched their weapons and had gotten control of the rebel elements that had the access codes to the nuclear launch. So if they had followed Captain Ramsey's advice, the old dog, the task, the contingency leader, they would have started a nuclear war and, you know, it would have been complete destruction on the planet. But they didn't listen to Captain Ramsey. Who they listened to was Lieutenant Hunter. What's interesting to me is that now that Lieutenant Hunter has combat experience, will he make that same decision down the road? To me, this movie kind of takes these two different types of people or leaders and puts them in front of us. But do new school guys or situational leaders or whatever, like, I don't think that Anand is saying this in his article, but this is just me talking now. Like, do you become that old dog? Do you become a contingency person, the task-oriented person? Maybe not. I mean, there are older people who have the ability to make people follow them. I don't like Bill Clinton, but he's still one of them. I mean, he should be maybe doing it from a jail cell, but that's a different topic. I think you could probably say Obama was a situational leader, had a natural ability for it. Doesn't mean I necessarily agree with the policies here, folks. I'm just here to talk about movies. But will that sort of natural ability stick with them even when they're faced with a particular task? So in this movie, you saw a lot of duty talk by Captain Ramsey and his followers, like, this is our mission, we're here to preserve democracy, we're to fight for America. Whereas if you remember in the scene when they were all eating before things had kicked off and they were all still friendly with each other, Captain Ramsey asked Lieutenant Hunter, I don't mean to imply that you're indecisive, meaning you're not as solid task oriented as me, like, I get things done, you like to think about things, which can be mistaken, I think, for indecisiveness. And he says, well, who do you think is the biggest threat? Us, Russia, whatever? And Lieutenant Hunter says, the biggest threat to humanity or the planet is war itself. And I think he means nuclear war in that sentence, but that's the difference, right? And that's what's put in front of us to sort of chew on. And I think the interesting thing about this movie is it's not, you do get the sense that the movie's sort of being, it's curating this perspective that Lieutenant Hunter might be right, because this is why movies are great, because it kind of curates a hunch for you and you get this feeling, I think he's right. But I think it leaves enough open to where you aren't sure. And you think to yourself, well, if they have launched nuclear missiles and we don't strike and we're the only ones left, you know, I guess they get away with it. I'm not sure. Like, we might as well destroy them too, is the thinking. But maybe you prevent them from launching more could be one of the arguments. One of the reasons that I think this movie sort of ages well over time is that it really kind of, at least subconsciously to me, puts the focus on leaders. Like, you have leaders in your life, right? You at your job or at in your household or in your country, and it, you know, we seem in the U.S. I don't know where you're watching this from, but it seems like we have an abundance of contingency leaders where they're very task oriented. They want to get the job done, and you're not entirely sure a lot of the time if the job involves your well-being and best interest. But as I mentioned, you do have people like, we'll just say Obama or other people who seem to have that situational leadership. They have a natural ability for it. But again, that doesn't necessarily mean you're going to make the right call. If in this movie in Crimson Tide, if it turns out that the Russians had launched, well, then we'd be talking a very different story. I mean, it's easy to say, since Lieutenant Hunter was right in this movie, that situational leadership sounds like the open-minded and correct way to go about it. But if they had launched, then Captain Ramsey would have been right. So then you'd have to maybe reevaluate everything if that was the way you were leaning. Okay, so that's it for this episode. Please click subscribe. It really helps so much. And patreon.com/arthouseradio if you'd like to support more. I am watching a couple movies right now. Lots of things to see at the theaters. How do you all feel about going to the movie theater now? Are you okay with it? I'm doing matinees, and it feels like there's not a ton coming out, but there's enough for you to go every week, I think. And I'm trying to catch a matinee during the week, once a week, and I've got some of those reviews coming up as well. All right, take care, my friends, and enjoy the movies. I gotta come up with a catchphrase. Why don't you guys send something in if you can think of anything, or maybe I should just do my job and think of something. Either way, I'll see you next week.